In this healthcare basics video, we're going to cover the flowchart, which will help us define how patients will move throughout the model. You can access the flowchart tool by clicking the flowchart button in the toolbar. We need to make connections between areas to make them accessible to patients. Unless you make these connections, patients won't be able to move or interact with objects in the model. As a general rule, it's better to make too many connections than too few. By default, the patient areas will be visible. You can click item objects at the top of the flowchart tool in order to make connections in the processing of items that play a role in the patient's treatment. To connect, either use the connect or disconnect buttons to enter connect and disconnect mode, or hold down one of the following hotkeys, A to connect and Q to disconnect. Whichever method you choose, click from one area to the next to connect them. When you're finished connecting, there should be a clear, unbroken flow between the patient arrival and the patient exit. Any gaps could mean patients are stuck somewhere during a simulation run. Don't be afraid to click and move things around as you flowchart. This tool can help you visualize the healthcare system you're modeling. You may have noticed that we've been using the word areas when we've been in the flowchart tool, as opposed to locations. Much like groups, areas are made up of one or more locations, making it easy to have a patient go to the first available bed in a bed area rather than having to specify a particular bed. Locations are added to an area automatically, but you can also choose a different area for the location or even create a completely new area in that location's quick properties. The flowchart also has a helpful button to toggle the list of locations within each area, which is a fast way to get a bird's eye view of the locations and areas in your model. Thank you for watching. Tune into the next video to learn about the patient track.